hug Lower Tar. Searching, searching, Sister Jane. Blow up,
Sean Lennon here at the Tibetan Freedom Concert. I'm here with Sonic Youth and Jackson Smith, Patti Smith's son, also a band member for her band. Very short and concisely and quickly and excitingly, I want you guys to tell me what about the Tibetan Freedom Concert made you want to participate?
It was just the fact that we were asked.
They began in New York City, simultaneous with the odious birth of the Reagan era. Sonic Youth have been among the world's premier musical gourmandizers, from their very beginnings as avatars of what would eventually transmogrify into America's dominant guitar rock paradigm. Sonic Youth's compositions relished the discord of disparate ideas as much as the discord of detuned guitars. They were already weaving threads of the Wilson Brothers' lyrical visions with the guitar sheets of Remco, Shaw, and Rampton, the note clouds of Yannis Xenakis, and the rhythmic bup of Creedence Clearwater Revival, when today's bands were still wetting their beds. Throughout a career that spans nearly two decades and is longer than the combined careers of the Beatles and Coltrane's classic quartet, Sonic Youth have continuously expanded in both horizontal and vertical stylistic planes. While it is safe to say that they have certain signature sounds, a chimingly propulsive motif, specific patterns of string disharmony, three instantly recognizable vocalists, the ways in which their overall sound has evolved is not so much defined by standard incremental steps as it is by amoebic blossoming. Unlike most bands whose new musical interests and discoveries are transparent and immediately highlighted, Sonic Youth have never allowed themselves to be so lazily obvious. The musical knowledge that they accrue between recordings is filed along with what's already in their cabinets, and it's referred to for reasons of aesthetics rather than novelty.
The drama of my consciousness is that having lost the world, I try to recover myself. But in this moment, I am lost.
Metal moments.
Metal moments.
Everyone must have metal moments.
We'll be right back.
It represents a slow tracking of ideas, really. The earthly recordings of Sonic Youth, so to speak. Coco Haley Gordon Moore sort of helped Wharton with some of the mixes. She would turn the light off when it was time to cut. She was privy to development of the material here in my apartment. So she was able to explain it to the engineer. Kim Gordon says, "A thousand leaves is a thousand plateaus of a headless organism." She refers to her song Female Mechanic Now on Duty as being inspired by the song Bitch by some famous Lilith-type female singer by the name of Meredith Brooks. In a sense, it's an answer song. In an attempt to make our LPs dateable, we'll probably now include an answer song to something from popular culture on each LP. We're not, as some people maintain, obsessed with pop culture so much as we're obsessed with its stratification and datability.